Hello everybody, this is Stefan Frostrider here, bringing you, finally, after hours of fighting, we are finally ready to get started on Polaris. This will be a two-part video, or not, this will technically be a two-part video. This is part one. It is Polaris, or it is, because it's really, it's going to be in the title anyway, so I'm okay saying this. It is time for Stefan Frostrider. I know you've spent so much time with him for that one video that I, for those two or three videos that I've done with him. I know, it's been very emotional, but it is time for our beloved hero to graduate now. I have done absolutely nothing with him for so long.
Is an auspicious day. Most auspicious. It's time we address a matter that is long overdue. Yes, indeed.
I wonder what's going on.
I remember when you first set out for Unicorn Way, bright-eyed and brimming over with potential. Oh, seems like just yesterday.
I have an urge now to see if I can speedrun this entire thing in less than 24 hours. Could you walk any more flat-footed? God. Sorry, my sister's walking flat-footed up the stairs.
The faculty is all in agreement. It's time for your official graduation from Raven.
Oh, so I destroyed a world and I get to graduate. Hooray!
It'll be quite an affair. Don't delay now. Mr. Lincoln awaits you in the Cabinet of Wonders. He will prepare you for the ceremony.
Awesome. The box disappeared. Interesting. So I see something. Let's see. Okay, so that shield is Celestia, kimono is Mushu. This little book is definitely Krakatopia. There is the Aztecan Lord of Winter Throne. That is Krakatopia again. That I think is Celestia, maybe. Zafaria, Grizzleheim, Winter Tusk. What's that? That looks familiar, but I can't quite place it. What is that? What on earth is that from? That I want to know where that's from. And then there's the Aquila statue, Ravenwood, the desk. A boiler from Marleybone, Big Ben from Marleybone, Chrysalis. No idea what that mirror is from. I don't know where half of this stuff is from. I'm sorry.
Hello there, young wizard. I hope you're as excited as I am.
Did they change his voice again?
Glasses perched on my bill. Such a landmark occasion. It's not.
I'm glitching through his face.
Ceremony in Ravenwood. In fact,
I'm so short.
It happened. I've had a cap and gown fitted just for you. Very elegant, I think. Put them on and step into the tapestry to reach the ceremony grounds.
This is quite interesting what's going on.
Headmaster Ambrose wants this day to be extra special. Many distinguished guests have come to congratulate you. Let's not keep them waiting.
I do not like Lincoln's new voice at all.
Made from rich cashmere, giving it a fine depth and
okay, so this is definitely for people that are older now, because I don't think anybody above the age of 15 or anybody below the age of 15 knows what cashmere is. I'm 18 and I don't know what cashmere is. I mean, I know it's a fabric, but that's it. Oh, look, the quest helper's broken again. Nice effects, though.
The grounds of Ravenwood. Decorated like never before. Colorful banners are everywhere, and a colorful array of guests as well.
Listen to that beautiful music. Let's see if we can identify the colors of the flags. Okay, so I see ice, fire, and... Okay. Ice, fire, and myth, storm, death, and life. There's no balance.
It is indeed a
most Oh, and I accidentally pressed that.
And to think it's all in your honor.
It's funny, because on the... when I was in the, what's it called? Wizard. Okay, let's see if we can see who all is here, so I don't have to do it for the next time. I don't know half these people. Honestly, I don't. I saved you one time. That's it. Wait, are you taller than, me? Okay, good. No, you're not. Wait, are you? You are slightly taller than me, and that makes me angry. Urg. Hey, there's Cyrus Drake. Oh, so he comes out. Wait, where's the other balance teacher? Where's the actual balance teacher? Oh, so he doesn't get to come? Rude.
Welcome, wizard. It is my distinct pleasure to call you before Great Bartleby this day to recognize your remarkable list of accomplishments.
You mean just guessing throughout the entire game? I've been with you for over 7 years. I made this wizard in like 2009, so that's 6 years now.
All of the esteemed guests who gathered here today are from you have not been with us at Raven. All of the esteemed
Okay, so I didn't miss something.
Gathered here today are familiar with your shrewd mind, your heroic spirit, and noble virtue.
I don't want to hear it. I'm embarrassed. I don't know where to turn because everyone is standing on all sides, and then there's the giant tree.
What a pleasure today is, wizard. Although I am fond of all my precious little snowflakes, you.
I don't want to be a special snowflake.
When you mastered the Colossus spell, I knew you would become a formidable ice wizard, and you've learned so much beyond that.
I never use it. Well, I guess I did use it quite a bit.
Nor could I be more honored to have you amongst the Council of Light. You've done me proud, my dear.
Wizard, you've been more than an exemplary student. You've been an inspiration. And on a personal note, you've become a dependable friend.
You've never done anything for me. I've always just been your little slave. What are you talking about, friend? You've never... Well, I suppose you gave me that one spell. But other than that, nothing. I wish there was that other teacher, Hiller. Where's the little balance teacher?
Certainly unexpected. And did you see Bartleby? I've never seen him quite so frightened.
He didn't look frightened at all. He didn't change his expression at all. He maybe looked like he might have sneezed or something, but he didn't look frightened.
There's Professor Wu inside the World Tree. Perhaps you should go and ask if she needs assistance. I hope you can discover the meaning of this. I'll be in my office.
Why can't you do it? You're much more powerful than me. I may be a graduate, but you're the headmaster. Why me? Why not you? My second video on this is not going to be very interesting, because I'm already asking all the questions now.
Goodness gracious, what happened? It looks like that chill wind has made Bartleby sick, but how could that be?
I don't know. How are you still alive when my narwhal is impaling you? That did absolutely nothing for my experience, okay?
Well, ever since the dawn of time, to see him sick, it worries me. I am ashamed to say, I don't even know what ails him. Maybe Bartleby himself knows what's wrong. Would you be a dear and go ask him?
Why can't you? It's like, what's wrong? Does like nobody know how to do anything, really?
Cold. Such a cold wind. Chills one right down to the roots. From whence did it come, though? That is the cause for concern. A far, far away feeling. Where land meets the sky. Oh, do not feel well. Tell Ambrose, there is trouble where land meets the sky. Yes, where land meets the sky.
That is an interesting voice acting, Bartleby. It's very, very interesting. I have to say that myself. I am not going to be using the narwhal pretty much. I'm going to have to go and get my little rhinoceros thing. No, I mean, the books are back.
Okay. Yes, our new graduate. I'm so proud. But you look worried. Is everything all right? Bartleby is sick, but nothing like this has ever happened. It's quite disturbing. Chilling, even. That wind must have been very cold.
Is it supposed to be playing this again? I don't think it is.
What did Bartleby say, though? Where land meets the sky. Sounds vaguely familiar. Perhaps something to do with Polaris. It's one of the worlds that old Cobb mentioned, is it? Oh dear. Yes, we need to look into this. We should ask Professor Drake. Cyrus, of course. He spent some time in Polaris, as I recall. Go ask if Bartleby's words make any sense to him.
Okay, now it's time for this one to be, Yeah, it's gonna be a two-part video, so what I'm gonna do actually is just go talk to Cyrus Drake, and since the quest helper isn't working, I have to just memorize where everyone is.
Back for more applause.
I just noticed I could have recorded these both at the same time.
Or is this something more serious?
Let me see. I'm just gonna.
The sky. Yes, that is a reference to Polaris. It lies at the very edge of the spiral, the horizon, as it were.
Yes, sorry about this, guys. I am doing something. Well, let me, Yeah, sorry about this sound again. And there goes that. Let me go check the properties again. And 1792 by 1344. So, 1792. 1344. Oh no. Okay. And I zoom it down. Zoom it down. Zoom it down. There we go. Now you can watch both of my wizards play at the same time. Of course, I'll have to do this. Yeah, I should probably shouldn't have been doing this. This is quite a dilemma. You know, I'm just gonna keep it like this for now.
Who might know, an old witch, Baba Yaga, as she's called. She was a friend once.
I went to the wrong place.
Baba Yaga's a bit of a recluse, hard to find. But she has a henchman, a former circus strongman, dubiously named Ivan the Great.
Take the spider. So sorry about this little bit of editing problems in the middle.
He can lead you to Baba Yaga.
On the plus side, now I no longer have to worry about just recording one at a time. I can record both of my wizards at the same time. Of course, then there comes the problem of the slight lag and the reduced quality, but... two Polaris. So now the one on the top... So now that the top left... Now that the ice is no longer the focus... I'm gonna do this, okay. Sound off. So now you gotta watch it all over again. And now the fire is the focus.
Wizard, it is so good to see you hale and hearty. I must tell you, we were all concerned for your safety. Now tell me what happened. Do not spare any details. Morgana. I understand there is no other way. We must learn all we can from her story, so future tragedies may be averted.
Yeah, I suppose that's true, but I mean, we did do the exact same thing that she did and learn shadow magic against the will of what you wanted us to do, so...
This news of old Cobb is troubling, but we shall just have to wait and see what tomorrow brings. New adventures for us all.
Very new adventures, and I'm very excited for it.
There you are. Today is an auspicious day. Most auspicious. It's time we address...
Just ignore the ice in the upper left-hand corner.
Yes, indeed. I remember when you first set out for Unicorn Way. Bright-eyed and brimming over with potential. Oh, seems like just yesterday.
Yes, yeah, sorry, I was not sure what exactly I was expecting.
Yes, you've done all that was expected, and more. The faculty is all in agreement. It's time for your official graduation from Ravenwood.
Ooh, I cannot wait.
Quite an affair. Don't delay now. Mr. Lincoln awaits you in the Cabinet of Wonders. He will prepare you for the ceremony.
So now you just get to watch my ice mess around while my fire graduates.
Hello there, young wizard.
Oh look, I'm no longer clipping into him.
As excited as I am, I can barely keep my reading glasses perched on my bill.
Well, it looks like you can rarely do that anyways, and it doesn't look like they'd be much help to you. I mean, they're so far away.
Such a landmark occasion. It's not every day we have a graduation ceremony at Ravenwood. In fact, I can't recall the last time it happened.
It just happened about 5 minutes ago.
I've had a cap and gown fitted just for you. Very elegant, I think. Put them on and step into the tapestry to reach the ceremony grounds.
Okay, give me...
Headmaster Ambrose wants this day to be extra special. Many distinguished guests have come to congratulate you. Let's not keep them waiting.
No, let's keep them waiting. I'm fine with keeping them waiting.
Casimir, giving it a fine depth and soft luster sheen, and the cap is quite stately.
Stately.
The grounds of Ravenwood are decorated like never before. Colorful banners are everywhere, and a colorful array of guests as well.
Well, they certainly are colorful.
It is indeed a most festive occasion, and to think it's all in your honor.
Some of these people I still don't even remember.
Welcome, wizard. It is my distinct pleasure to call you before Great Bartleby this day to recognize your remarkable list of accomplishments.
Oh, no. No. No, no, no. What happened? No, oh, man. Get... Oh, my God, Windows 8. No one likes you. Sorry about that. Windows 8 decided to mess up on me there for a second. Everything got smushed together, and it really got annoying for me.
All of the esteemed guests who have gathered here today are familiar with your shrewd mind, your heroic spirit, and noble virtue. None more so than your distinguished teacher, Professor Dahlia Valmeyer.
So many useful treasure cards I'm getting on my ice.
I cannot begin to express my pleasure at how you've grown. When you first came to me, you were but a fleeting spark. And now you burn like a phoenix. You have warmed so many fragile hearts and kindled so many brave souls. Wizard, you are a constant light in the darkness. And I can't wait to see the paths you'll blaze in years to come.
Wizard, you've been more than...
I can't wait to see what Cyrus Drake's is for this.
And on a personal note, you've become a dependable friend. And so, without further ado, I hereby pronounce you a
member okay, that was interesting.
Of the Ravenwood School of Magic. With honors, even.
With honors. And the quest helper is still borked. Yay.
Certainly unexpected. And did you see Bartleby? I've never seen him quite so frightened. And there goes Professor Wu inside the World Tree. Perhaps you should go and ask if she needs assistance.
This is probably interesting. This is probably an interesting video for you guys.
In my office.
I mean, on one side, you have me graduating. On the other side, you see me fighting lost souls.
Goodness gracious, what happened? It looks like that chill wind has made Bartleby sick. But how could that be? Bartleby's been standing here.
So as you can see, my fire wizard has quite a bit more experience points than my ice wizard, so he's gonna get his level 108 spell first. to say? Most likely, anyways.
I don't even know what ails him. Maybe Bartleby himself knows what's wrong. Would you be a dear and go ask him?
I mean, it could always come down to the fact that they'll both get to level 108 long before the actual quest begins. Long before the actual quest you need to fight, you have to complete to get into Polaris begins.
Cold. Such a cold wind. Chills one right down to the roots.
Sorry, yeah.
From whence did it come, though? That is the cause.
Okay, so novice diviners have solar saber cap and mantle ray mounts. This is fine. This is fine.
Trouble where land meets the sky. Yes, where land meets the sky.
Tower shield for the win. Ah, the little dance is so cute. Tomorrow, Ambrose, time to get rid of my graduation garb. Yeah, I still need to go do Bone Master. I still need to go do Rattle Bones.
Yes, our new graduate.
You don't sound very happy for me.
It's quite disturbing, chilling even. That
chilling. Yeah.
What did Bartleby say, though? Where land meets the sky. Sounds very familiar. Perhaps something to do with Polaris. Polaris is one of the worlds that old Cobb mentioned, is it not? Yes, we need to look into this. We should ask Professor Drake. Cyrus, of course. He spent some time in Polaris, as I recall. Go ask if Bartleby's words make any sense.
I wonder what Cyrus was doing in Polaris to begin with. I really do.
Professor Drake has a hunch about this. If not, I don't know where else to turn.
I actually end up getting caught in another quest. I'm just looking something up really quickly. Thank you. I'm just looking up time zones really quickly. Sorry about this. Sorry. I really should not be looking up time zones right now, but I just have to. It's just for something important later tonight. So in 2 hours, yeah. Oh no, it's an hour. Yeah, 2 hours now. Yeah, 2 hours.
Back for more applause.
Sorry for making my ice wizard be so boring in the corner for so long. No, you don't say. Where the land meets the sky. Yes, that is a reference to Polaris. It lies at the very edge of the spiral, the horizon, as it were.
But why it would make Bartleby ill?
I have no idea. Perhaps there's someone in Polaris who might know. An old witch named Baga Yaga. I said Baga Yaga. You were going to become a professor. How do you know about the Arcana professors? That's interesting. How does Cyrus know about Arcana professors?
Take the spiral door to Polaris. It leads to the capital, Walrusburg. Ask around for Ivan the Great. Hopefully he can lead you to Baba Yaga.
Okay, so now it's time to bring my ice wizard up to Polaris. And now it's time to move back to ice, because it is Polaris, so it only makes sense that the ice would get the first starting pick. It only makes sense. It really does, because ice, Polaris, polar, ice caps, melting, global warming. Woo! Off to Polaris. It's gonna have to load, isn't it? Yes!
Stop right there! Before you may proceed, you must hear the official welcome to Walruskberg. On behalf of Her Most Grandioseness, Empress Antusket I, I welcome you to Walruskberg, crown jewel of Polaris. Enjoy our glorious city. But abide by the
they finally added mana wisps.
No merrymaking, no fishing, no magic, no singing, and no leaving the city. A curfew is in effect in some parts of the city from sundown to sunrise. This is a winter season, so the next sunrise is many months away. Also, in accordance with law 3-1604, I must ask, what is your business in our fair city, Ivan? Ivan who? You mean Ivan the Terrible. Bah! Ivan is under arrest. That rabid beast nearly destroyed the Inn of the Midnight Sun. Go see for yourself, if you must.
Follow me, Marcus. Follow me, even though yours is the quest helper that is working. Yeah, maybe I should have followed you. I don't think I'm going the right way. Yeah, I wasn't going the right way. Ice wasn't going the right way. Not in the slightest. Yep. Oh, what this? What's this? What's this? What's this? Interesting. Selling a pip deck? I don't have enough gold for that. house. I have no idea where my fire wizard is in comparison to my ice wizard. Yeah, I'm just gonna port. This is probably quite interesting for some of you. Trust me, it's quite interesting for me. I never expected myself to be doing a double video like this. I expected to just be doing a single video, like I've always been doing. I think I'm going to be doing this from now on, with like a...
The inn is quiet, and you don't
with like my other ice and fire.
At least not in here. The innkeeper looks frustrated, however, and he keeps glancing nervously at the door to the back room.
I don't want any more trouble. The inspectors told me to keep my mouth shut, so I'm not saying a word, not once I hear. If you have questions, you have to go back into the feasting hall and talk to Inspector Clouseau.
That's a Pink Panther joke. That is a Pink Panther joke. Tell me otherwise, you'd be wrong. If that is a Pink Panther joke, and there is no way that I am going to say anything otherwise than that. Okay, I was not expecting that to happen if I... Okay. Probably should have put in some prisms. On the plus side, my fire has insane pierce. I don't know if you can see it that well. 21% armor piercing. That is weird. Why are the sound effects not playing in Polaris? This is interesting. Oh yeah, I've been waiting so long to do these videos, and I'm listening to the criticism that you guys gave me with my other Polaris videos, and I will be doing the thing where I actually listen to the dialogue. Okay, let's do that. And the mouse is gone for this. Okay, there it is. Prism? Or not prism, trap? Wonder what this is, Heckhound? Oh no, it's a Freet! Even better! I love you, Inspector Clouseau. I love you so much. Thank you for using a Freet on me. It's not like I wanted you to do that or anything. I didn't want you to do it at all. Why? Why do you hurt me this way? Why do you hurt me in this way, Inspector Clouseau? I will be right back. It took so much restraint on my part to resist putting my ice into Polaris the day it aired, the day it launched, because he was ready. He could have done it. I could have done the ice graduation video about 3 days ago when Polaris dropped on Wednesday. But I wanted to do Polaris with both my ice and my fire still had to finish up Chrysalis, so I waited. Well, I didn't really wait. I had to go power level my... You're gonna do that to me. I'm gonna do it back at you. I don't care if this Efreet isn't going to do anything. You already have incredible resist to get it against it, so it's not going to do anything to begin with. The part that I'm doing the Efreet for is for the 90% weakness. That's the only part that matters to me. I probably should have done this on the other guy, but he wouldn't have died from it, and it wouldn't have been worth it. Exactly 100. That is quite interesting. Ooh, and Pierce Gem. Thank you, Pet. Thank you for the Pierce Gem. Thank you so much. That may have sounded sarcastic, but it wasn't. That was actually legitimate. Oh yes, I am happy to have a Pierce Gem and a round of stun. Thank you. Now I get to pass again. So thank you for that. Should do more. That is it. I'm doing this. And of course it fizzles. And of course that fizzles too. I mean, why not? I will say that I like. Okay, that is interesting. I was not expecting that to happen. I'm sorry about that. My family apparently doesn't know the meaning of the words "I'm busy now." Let's see if I'm actually able to do this. Probably not, because that's minus 65, so this spell has 10% accuracy. Okay. Spells that have 10% accuracy can go. Oh no, that has a 15% accuracy, my bad. But the 40% accuracy that was casting a spell that had 100% accuracy as base, oh no, that's never going to cast. Of course. Did I turn off the sound effect? Okay, no, they're just really, really quiet in Polaris for some reason. Okay, that is interesting. That is very interesting, I have to say. Let's do a quick heal. I'm sorry, I did not plan for the sound effects to go off. Tempest. Or Stormcat, that's fine too. Just gonna take a round and finish that guy off with Marcus. Of course they block it. I mean, why not? I mean, it's not like a Kingsisle made the argument that it's not like Kingsisle made the argument that criticals weren't gonna be blocked as much anymore. That is kind of an interesting glitch right there, though. So this guy has an inherent 10% pierce. Let's see, will it get past? Oh, it actually did get past. Huzzah! And it still only did 2,240 damage. That's resist for you, folks. That is resist for you. Oh, look. It's gonna fizzle. It fizzled. I am so surprised. Now you get to fizzle. Or better yet, you get to die. Perish now, wizard. Or perish now. This is such an ease compared to the other bosses from Chrysalis and stuff, where they had 20,000 HP. I don't even care about the pierce. I mean, whoop-de-doo, you pierce. Huzzah. Bye-bye. Interesting. I don't know why anyone would use that.
May come back and hassle me later, but it was worth it just to see the look on his face. You're a friend of Ivanson. Oh, you've never met him. Don't listen to the inspectors. Ivan's the best husky I know. This wasn't his fault. The inspectors are to blame. They were roughing up some innocent penguins, and Ivan intervened.
Penguins.
Took 10 inspectors to restrain him. Locked him up in the Bastille now, like everyone else who steps out of line. Packed like sardines. I can't imagine how they fit them all. Listen, you want to help Ivan out? You're no friend to the inspectors, so I'll tell you. Talk to Red Rosa at Lacombe's Press.
Anyways, this has been Stefan Frostrider bringing you the first part of Polaris. I thank you all for watching my videos. I am sorry about that interruption we had in the middle where I went to start editing and adding in my fire wizard. So anyways, I thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoy the rest of this Popping into Polaris series that will be going on for the next maybe week and a half until I finish Polaris. Okay, it'll probably take me a little bit more than a week because I have to record it now and I can't skip the dialogue. But anyways, thank you all for watching my videos. I hope you all enjoyed it. And I look forward to doing more videos in the future for Polaris. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to like and leave a comment down below in the comments. If you want to see the rest of this video series in the future, please remember to subscribe to my channel so I can keep you updated on Stefan and Marcus's adventures throughout Polaris. Once again, this is Stefan Frostrider playing as Stefan Frostrider, signing out. Thank you for watching.